Okay, hi everyone. Thank you so much for joining me in this section. I hope we are having an exciting time at the Singapore National Library. We are quickly going to look at connecting library metadata to Wikidata, a semantic web approach to information discovery. My name is Omorodion Okonrai. I'm currently the head of e-library services at Glorious Vision University in Nigeria, West Africa. It's my honor to be doing this short, to give this short talk, which will be followed by a practical section to be handled by my colleagues, other librarians on ground, Prue. And I'm sure we're going to have an exciting time together. So we're talking about connecting library metadata to Wikidata, but why do we need to start thinking about this? Now, this topic was born out of the current problems that are associated with library metadata in our current dispensation. We know that technology has helped improve library data, library metadata, and we now have different cataloging systems and different OPAC system, online public access catalog, that allows for the sharing of library bibliographic records, otherwise known as library metadata. Now, but the challenge with existing technologies is that these technologies are oftentimes domiciled in each institution. So what it does is that it makes each institution having their own records. There is no aspect of interconnectedness among different records, different knowledge, and also not to mention the fact that there is limited visibility to these records. And oftentimes, you find that these records are only domiciled within the institutions and linked to the institution website. So it creates a kind of unlimited visibility, which in turn also affects accessibility to these bibliographic records that could impact the use of information resources in the library. So that's why this session is it was conceived to discuss Wikidata as a technology that could be leveraged on by libraries to help improve the discoverability of library materials and also the interconnection of libraries and institutions together. But before then, it's important we have a brief understanding of what exactly is Wikidata and how does it fit in to library in today's dispensation. Wikidata, as it has been commonly defined, is a free multilingual knowledge base of linked open data that can be edited by humans or machines alike. The technology is seen as a knowledge base of linked data. It contains structured data with entities and with entities about people, places, institutions, organizations, and so on and so forth. So it's a powerful tool for improving accessibility to information, and it was also conceived, it was launched in 2012. It's because of the linked nature of Wikidata, it is considered a semantic web technology, and it allows for use of structured data in a linked environment. So how exactly does Wikidata fit into libraries in our current discussion? How does it fit? Wikidata as a technology oftentimes can be used as a hub for our library data. Now, what does this mean? We found out that libraries can actually contribute their own bibliographic data onto Wikidata as a way of creating access to this to their records. And this oftentimes will be more will be very useful to libraries with less technological infrastructure and less technical support to create their own open catalog system to enhance discovery. And I think libraries, especially in different regions, from developing regions to developed regions, we find this technology very useful as a whole. Then there's also the advantage of linking of collections together, as well as bibliographic records in an ever-expanding world. With Wikidata, libraries and librarians can help link their collections together by sharing relationships between one collection and the other. For example, collections by the same author, resources published or authored by a particular author can be linked together. Then also, it can be linked with other institutions, other libraries using external identifiers. Then there is also the fact that Wikidata creates room for enriched bibliographic data. And this could be taken, for example, in a regular cataloging system. We create information for, let's say, the name of an author, the title of a work, the place of publication, the year of publication, and so on and so forth. So let's see, what if, instead of just having the name of an author, we can have more information about the author, for example, like where the author schooled, other publications that he has, and other libraries, for example, that has content about that author and things like that. And this can be made possible with the use of Wikidata because it can help to show this link, this relationship, and connect one entity with another entity. So this is a huge advantage that Wikidata have, and it has the capability and potential to create a giant open knowledge ecosystem that could help improve scholarship and research across the world. So that's why libraries must begin to embrace Wikidata, not as a replacement to existing cataloging systems or information retrieval systems, but as an addition to it, as a way of creating a new level of openness to its collections. Then there's also the advantage of using the query service in Wikidata, such as the Wikidata Spark query service, to help analyze library bibliographic data and create visual image that could be used to make informed decision. So these are other advantages that that libraries could gain by using Wikidata and creating their meta by and connecting their metadata into Wikidata so as to help improve overall service delivery in the libraries. Then there's also the issue of linked access to a detailed bibliographic data of people involved in the work, which is what I've earlier explained as containing more information about the authors of a work. So, but when we talk about Wikidata, the question that often comes to mind is what makes Wikidata suitable for library metadata? Now, we've already highlighted the importance of Wikidata being the fact that it creates a better visibility for library bibliographic records such that instead of the bibliographic record being domiciled in only one cataloging system, it can be visible, it can be seen from people from different parts of the world. And let's say, for example, my library, Glorious Vision University Library, we have our own cataloging, our own library management systems that allows us to catalog and share our bibliographic records with our users. But what if we can add our cataloging information to Wikidata? It means that people beyond our immediate environment can have access to it. So it means for people in Singapore, for example, can access the records. People in the United States, in Europe, can access the records and so on and so forth. So this ultimately helps to improve the discoverability of library resources and create a better learning environment for not only readers, but also researchers and information seekers in general. Then there is also the ultimate advantage of interoperability between libraries. It's usually by libraries can actually foster collaboration and cooperation by collectively contributing bibliographic records to Wikidata. Now, there's a project we are currently working on in Nigeria, which is we're currently piloting Wikibase in Nigerian libraries, and we are currently exploring how we can actually use Wikibase technology, which is a software that powers Wikidata. We are exploring how we can use it to create a union list catalog for different libraries in Nigeria. So I get to talk more on that later on in the course of this presentation. But the goal is that with Wikidata technology, we can actually foster cooperative cataloging among libraries, and libraries could engage in cooperation and update their records together. What this can do is that it will help improve the standardization of bibliographic materials and help create better, more quality metadata for libraries, and also help libraries that are not having enough skilled manpower to create their own bibliographic records or metadata by themselves, so they can actually work with existing metadata. So all this helps to make the library create a better learning environment for not just the libraries, but also for the librarians themselves. Then there's also the advantage, the fact that Wikidata is highly visible, very visible, and it's connected to Google and other AI agents that will help in the area of search and retrieval of information from the library. Not to mention the aspects of querying and analyzing data from the library. So this is an image that was uploaded by GCNLW. It's a pennant manuscript. It's a visualization of the pennant manuscript that has been uploaded into Wikidata by the National Library of Wales. And that is a notable example of a library that has actually contributed thousands of material bibliographic records to Wikidata. And these records include books, manuscripts, maps, and other kinds of information resources. So it shows the interconnection, the links between different resources. So what this can do is that with Wikidata, we can create visual images of library collections. We can create timelines, create different, we can work around our data and play around it to create different, image or different data that could help make informed decision. So the advantages of Wikidata are enormous. But having known this, how then can we now contribute our content to Wikidata? Now we're going to have a short a practical session after this brief talk, which is going to be handled by librarians on ground to be led by Prue. So it's important we know that part of the ways we can actually connect our library metadata to Wikidata is by we can do that by manually adding Wikidata items, creating Wikidata items for our library collections. And there we can add different statements. For example, you want to create a Wikidata item for a book titled Things Fall Apart by Chinua Achebe. You can get to write the name of the author, the title of the work, the place of publication, the year of publication. Then this can also be linked to Chinua Achebe as a person. So you can see that the link, it links different entities together, both persons and organizations and things like that. Then there's also the option of batch uploading records, bibliographic records, using quick statements, which is actually allowed within the Wikidata environment. So one can actually upload large amounts of bibliographic records at once after the records have been cleaned and ensure that they follow the same data type and consistency. One can upload it, but the disadvantage this has over the manually created Wikidata items is that librarian may not have so much 100% control over the data that has been uploaded. There may be some inconsistency among the records, but with the manual style, you have ultimate control over what you want to add, the kind of statements you want to add. So we are not just speaking jargons. We are not just speaking abstract things. Different libraries across the world have actually embraced Wikidata and have actually contributed their library bibliographic data to Wikidata in order to create and improve knowledge base, global knowledge base. And the goal is that after this presentation, more libraries will embrace Wikidata and actually contribute their bibliographic records to Wikidata in order to create a more improved scholarly ecosystem. So there are notable examples of libraries all over the world that have embraced Wikidata and have contributed parts of their records or bibliographic data to Wikidata. Of course, notable among them is the Library of Congress, which has actually led the way in contributing metadata to Wikidata, and that they've done since 2015. And there's also the Texas State Universities. These are just few examples. Of course, many other institutions, libraries, other GLAM institutions have also contributed have also contributed their own bibliographic records to Wikidata. And these are just a few examples. So in the course of this presentation, we are going to look at three case studies of libraries that have actually contributed parts of their bibliographic records or metadata to Wikidata. And we have one of the case study I noted here is the London School of Economics Library, which has actually connected over 2,000 records of their library metadata to Wikidata. And the goal of this is to improve the discoverability of their materials. And they have also linked these records to other external identifiers to help improve the visibility of the records. The second case study here is that of the University of Texas Libraries. The University of Texas Libraries have created over 1,000 items for its Benson Latin American collection on Wikidata using a tool called the Mix and Match. And that matches external catalogs with Wikidata. So ultimately, several libraries have contributed bibliographic records to Wikidata, and more are still encouraged to do so. So the third case study here is that of the National Library of Wales that has linked over 100,000 items to Wikidata so as to help in not just creating visibility, but also in the aspect of querying the data to create visuals, images that could be used for planning and decision-making. So ultimately, part of the collections that have been added by the National Library of Wales to Wikidata includes information about books, newspapers, journals, maps, manuscripts, amongst others. Well, aside from Wikidata, there are also the similar technology, which is Wikibase, with notable examples being the German National Library and the French National Library. Also exploring Wikibase as a linked data tool to help improve visibility and interconnectivity of library collections. So coming back to Africa, there's also the example of the BAM library from the University of Ghana, where they've also contributed parts of their library records to Wikidata. So aside connecting records to Wikidata, I also want to just quickly bring to our attention the use of the pilot project on Wikibase that is currently being piloted in Nigerian libraries. So we have a team of librarians in Nigeria being supported by Wikimedia Deutschland to pilot Wikibase, which is a software that powers Wikidata in Nigerian libraries. And the goal of this is to help create a union catalog or an interconnected catalog for Nigerian libraries, whereby we can actually link the records from one Nigerian library to another Nigerian libraries. So part of the goal for the pilot Wikibase project in Nigerian libraries is to support Nigerian librarians to create their own Wikibase.cloud user accounts. And you know that Wikibase.cloud is a software as a service platform that is that allows users to set up their own Wikibase instances. So the goal is for librarians to set up different Wikibase instances for their libraries and or populate those Wikibase instances with their bibliographic records and connect them with other libraries for improved discoverability and visibility. Then there's also, of course, linking of the bibliographic records among the selected libraries that have been piloted. Then also, training of at least 30 Nigerian librarians to work in a linked data, in a Wikidata and Wikibase environment. So using Wikidata or Wikibase is not just all simple. There are also challenges that we have to consider if we are to fully adopt Wikibase in libraries, if we are to fully connect our resources to libraries. Look to note, there are certain challenges that we have to watch out for before we engage in connecting our metadata to Wikidata. And part of it is top on that list is the issue of sustainability. How sustainable is the practice? beyond just connecting a batch records or a current records, how do we hope to sustain the issue? And this can be very challenging, especially since connecting library metadata to Wikidata is not usually part of the workflow in many libraries. So this can become very problematic when there is no continuity or sustainability of the practice. And it can be difficult to update the records if this is not part of the library workflow. Then there's also the fact that it can be time consuming. Working in a Wikidata environment can be time consuming, especially when one is not already familiar with the Wikidata environment. And that means one has to start learning new set of skills, how to use the Wikidata query service, amongst others. And of course, this knowledge are not taught in library schools, so it requires more learning and more training on the part of the librarians. Then also, other notable challenge is the fact that libraries may not really have total control over the knowledge that are shared, over the data that are shared on Wikidata. And this is because Wikidata is a collaborative platform that has been edited by people from different parts of the world. And it can bring cause a sense of concern to librarians when you may not have absolute control. But I think overall that the advantages of Wikidata, it supersedes the challenges, and one can always work around the challenges. So to conclude, Wikidata is a powerful tool, and all librarians, we encourage librarians, Wikimedias, and other open knowledge advocates to help connect libraries together by contributing more library data, bibliographic data to Wikidata, as this will help to create more connectivity among libraries, among institutions, and also create more a richer knowledge base of linked data, which ultimately will help improve scholarship and improve an open knowledge ecosystem for an open scholarly ecosystem for our society. So we know that the future is connection is to bring the future goal is to bring libraries together, bring a knowledge house together, and Wikidata can help achieve that. So the call for action for all of us is to sit back and think, just give yourself some time to think, what can I do to improve accessibility to library records? And how can I, as an individual, as a librarian, help my library to be more visible? And what actions do I need to take? Those are questions I want us to ponder on, even as we go into the practical session with my colleagues on ground. So I'm going to stop here, and I want to thank you all for listening to this talk. Here also some useful link. I'll drop the link to the slides so you can also have access to it. So if you have any question, please do not hesitate to write me, okwangaio@yahoo.com. I'll be more than happy to respond. So I'm open to, of course, more interactions about this, more engagement about this, and of course, more collaboration. Thank you so much, and do have a lovely time. Thank you.